the good things which may not be very relevant to what you're doing. When we're doing messages, and that is almost all of you do that because you have phones that you're sending an SMS, you want to take a shot. I find it hard to read my daughter's SMS. Well, she has an habit of putting XOXO. So I couldn't know what the hell is this. So when it comes to communal, you say it's a good. You must write proper English. Don't put initials because somebody might not understand what those initials are. So don't use those applications. Just write the full name as it is. You must have a cover letter. A cover letter is a summary, basically, of what you need to, what you've done. There are other aspects you can put on that. What the professional will tell you, you need to market yourself well. Begin with a summary of qualification session. That suits your marketing skills and experience. You must be able to demonstrate results. So if you are going to sell for me credit cards, assuming you've been in that line, you can demonstrate to me by telling me, in your previous life you did so much, you were able to sell so much. That is when you're showing me results oriented CV. So it's just going to be basically that I did this, I did that. Show me, but demonstrate to me what you've already done or what you can be able to do. Please be accurate. When you're setting your skills, your qualifications, you must be accurate on that. You must make your points within a short time of your CV. Make it readable. If you can avoid graphics, the better. And if you can avoid personal statistics, that will be very well. And I got invited to three, including public service. So, in your case at times, for the bank now we've changed, you go to our website, you get the open opportunities. Because again, the money we used to send CVs to your uncle, please give so and so. For KCB now, that is not necessary anymore because there is a section for open jobs. And that's where you go and apply. Again, the application is online. What basically happens is me as a branch manager here, when I have a shortage or I have a need for staff, I'll ask my head office, tell them, I need this number of people for this position. I need three people to help me in sales. So when I put in that request and they agree with me that there's that need, they go to the database. You see, you apply online, so they are all put in that database. And I told you we use three criteria, age, and the past, you have a degree, and the past those subjects. Then you are put in that database. In that application within the system, they ask you, at the end of the day, they'll ask you where you want to work. And they give you opportunity to choose three towns you might want to work. So you put one, two, and three. Yeah. So if among the ones you've chosen, Bungoma is among them, when they run the database, they'll ask, who are these people who applied for Bungoma, from Bungoma? So they pick them out. Now those are the ones who will be subjected to the interview. So at times it's also good to be sly in these applications. 70% of new entrants, they want to work in Nairobi. Nairobi is too competitive. I know there's so many new opportunities in Nairobi, yes, but it's also a very big challenge. So at times it's good to start from machine learning. And then you work backwards towards where you want to eventually be. So for free advice, if you can avoid Nairobi and victims, the better. Or the higher the chances of you getting that opportunity. Once you're inside the system, it's easier to work out the movement. Speak positively about your co-workers and former employers, for those who might have worked elsewhere. Re-interview, if you can avoid it, avoid both bad mouthing, what do they call it?
Bad mouthing.
Yeah, bad mouthing. People you are working with or your employer. Because of what? When you leave, you do the same. And doesn't add value anyway. It's good to talk positively. So you need to talk positively about co-workers and from employer. When your interview is done, when you're closing the interview, emphasize your interests, summarize your qualifications, thank the interviewers for the opportunity, find out when you can call for follow-up. So if you're the person who then partakes the Ruaraka things, on that day, if you can avoid it, the better. Or if you smoke, it's not a crime. But it's not good habit when you're speaking. The first thing they smell is that form of alcohol. It's very bad in you. Or if you drink, then you have to brush thoroughly so that that, or whatever it is. And don't come chewing gum. It's bad to appear. When you're going for that interview, the manner in which you dress is very critical. So there are many ways of dressing. You can dress for a wedding. You can dress for church. You can dress for casual. But you must dress for an interview. There are basic things which then kill you during the interview. It's what they said, that they can smell you before they see you. You know? When I was in high school, it was a boarding school, and we came, at times we had the opportunity of girls who come in to visit. It's called a debate, whatever it was. And when you're looking for that event, we take a good shower. And I remember, you'll use your cologne and you'll borrow your friends. So by the time they put on like five different colognes. I don't know how it was meant. But it works hammer. Because nobody complained. But for me, please don't do that. Well, when you enter, the first thing is the smell before they've seen you. Or you're late for that interview, so the first thing you've been rushing, so the first thing they smell is the sweat on you. There's another problem called the painted face syndrome. This is a thing mainly for the ladies. Their makeups are out of town for other activities, but for them to make it polite. They'll make it too flashy. We can't see past the tie. In that you go for that interview and you put in a flashy tie. And that's the only thing they're looking at. Everybody forget who you are. Make it modest. The good thing about university, you are liberal to do whatever you want to do. Well, for interns again, it's good to understand the company you're going to. And I'll go come and show you the ones, the dress code for the bank. Because with this kind of attachment we're going to do with the professor, I foresee many of you going to the bank. So it's good to understand what we do, what we don't. So that if they will come for the interview, you'll know what well. You must understand what they do, how they do things. Because I say, for those who come for attachment to the bank, there's a particular way we're looking at things, the way they should be done. Confidentiality is about to one of the things. We cannot afford rudeness. I believe that the university here has its own way of doing things. It's good to understand your employer. What do they do? How do I want things to be done? And do them that way. Don't come with your own orders of arranging, which might not work very well for that particular employment. There is something you needed to touch on. And this is specifically ways in which you can poison your career. You've been employed, yes. But along the line, things may not work out for you. One is possessing poor people skills. Whereby you are long ranger and you're just some goofy for Kilamutu. That's one clear way of killing your career. You must be respectable to your juniors and seniors for the young man. But if you are pleasant to everybody, that means you also will be pleasant to your customers. Another thing is not being a team player. Most institutions, they want team players because you're working with other people. You're working in finance, you're working with IT, whatever. So if you're not a team player, chances of progression are very limited. Nowadays, the way we live, most people want to wear tight schedules. So if you cannot meet your deadlines, again, you have your issues with both co-workers, and I'll check them out. You see, the good thing about lending, I might interview you for even 1 hour. But out of that 1 hour, the first 10 minutes or 15, I've already made up my mind whether I'm giving you or not. So the other 45 minutes, I'm looking for reasons to support or to decline. So the same thing when you look at an application, you can tell whether it has substance or not. So I'm going to pick them and go through them and say, of course, I want to go with this 45 application. Since I've helped him do his job, he's happy. So after 6 months, there was a big difference in productivity. I had so much. So they asked me, how come you're doing so much? But the truth of the matter is, I was able to go to my boss. I went to my boss and I said, I'm not right. So you must know your boss in a nutshell. You don't have to know him, but you must know your boss. You must build your network. Even within the institution, wherever you are, you must know which department thinks, what helps you to do things. So when it's a problem, it's very easy to go to that area of support. You must get noticed in whatever you do. You must look the part. So if you want to be the VC, you must look like the VC. You must carry the ambience of the VC guys. Make your own opportunities and carry that and it happens. You must have patience. The last one is you must be in the right place at the right time. The things which happen. But because you know something is going to happen, you position yourself in that position. So if they are setting a new department, it makes sense to you, start working towards, because of this. So you want to work towards getting that area for you. In fact, I'll urge you once you finish please struggle and go for the next degree. And the next degree which you're going for, go for a degree which then makes sense to you or adds value to your brand. Because as long as I can say, we employed you in the first degree the way you are, you ain't getting any bonus. It's not that like, because you have one degree, you suck, no. But for job enhancement, it's good to have that. But bottom line, you're lucky you are students of a great university. So take up a big opportunity of this university and go it further by the jobs you do. But the day you go for that job, put your best foot forward and give it all that it takes. So, Professor, I'm a church, I think I want to stop there. And I want to thank the Babi University for inviting me. Thank you.